Oh my gosh, it's a cute little pug.
I look so weird. I put on my shoes and now I'm actually wearing all gray. I packed leggings and I put them on and realized
they weren't leggings. They were capris.
And I was like, let's not wear that one.
No,
like,
I wore that the other day.
No. Because I wasn't really thinking. I was like,
your coat's still up there, right?
Yeah.
Is there anything else we need to gather up for you?
No.
Okay.
Oh, this.
I'm thinking, head on home.
I know.
And then we're going to stop at Target and pick up a couple things, okay?
Like more butter?
That might be on the list. I may also make another stop after we're out for your lesson, but he for sure has a prescription that needs to be refilled and a few other things that we need.
Yeah.
Devin needs legal pads, but I have to be back here by 4:30 to get him signed up so that everybody can use my online room.
For nothing.
Toby's like, are you leaving? Take me with you.
You always want to come, Toby, but it's too cold. It's too cold for you to come.
You all get too cold.
Sorry.
Kevin?
I'm gonna go take Hannah home and run to Target. I'll get your little pads. And then I'll be back to
you just so
I know. Yep.
What are you?
I'm watching Cute Animal Completion.
So dumb, it's genius. What?
No clue.
What are they doing to our shoes?
What do you mean? What?
Oh, they're wearing onesies. They're chimpanzees in onesies.
He's like, it's human sitting. It's man sitting.
That's sexist.
Yeah, you're assuming it's gender. Well, I can tell.
No, he said it's
by
man.
By weight.
Well, it's not even assuming gender. He said it's man sitting. I'm sorry, but a woman sits like that too.
Yeah, not too.
I know. I guess. Yes. It's person sitting.
Hey, no.
Oh my gosh, it's a corgo.
Not true.
Oh no, what happened to it?
It's licking the window.
Oh.
That dog doesn't even care about
the vacuum.
That's one weird dog.
See, if we could do that, and we would totally do that to Toby. Just vacuum him a lot.
Oh,
he finally doesn't even care that much about hair dryers. That's cute.
Huskies make the weirdest noises.
Are you sure that's on a Malamute?
That's a husky.
Are you sure it's on a Malamute?
Yes.
How do you know?
Because it is.
Malamutes look a lot similar to them. Frenchie will go.
Oh, he's getting a bat. It's like, I like this massage. The Snoop Challenge!
What?
The Snoop Challenge.
What's that?
They've got a lobster.
Wait, what's the Snoop Challenge?
Is it a fake lobster?
What's the Snoop Challenge?
Snoot.
What's that?
There's so many huskies.
What's the Snoop
Challenge? It's where you make a shape with your hand. dog just snoots.
Snoots?
Snoot.
A snoot?
Yeah.
And snoot?
Or like snoot.
Or like snoot?
Anything. You just make a shape.
Or
and
like
the dog goes snoot. Sure. That looks like a gang sign.
What? What does?
That?
This?
Whatever you're trying to do?
This?
I don't know, yeah, that looks like a gang symbol.
What?
Alright, ready, girls?
Yes!
I thought you said gang. Gang.
Alright, I'm in the garage.
Do you think I'll someone want this?
Maybe, I'll take it. Wait, can you have the room?
Yeah, I'll put it in here.
I also have the wine.
It's like a Tolo. Except it's a Tordo.
I'm bringing.
It's a Tordo.
He was just laying on his back, wagging its tail. I'm bringing a shirt, cookies, and movies I did not have before.
Hey, Milwaukee Public Schools wants you to know that there is school tomorrow.
Oh, there is school tomorrow?
See, I was just thinking, we're going to have people back to school on a Friday, and nobody's going to come. So it's basically just going to be like last Wednesday when nobody came.
Nobody's
going to
be doing
it
last Friday.
They call it even, no, it's like,
this is MPS, things are different.
Things are different.
Yes. Right, Emma?
MPS is dumb.
Oh, so much that. There are significant cultural differences among certain groups of people within the inner city.
Yes.
Alright, got everything up?
Today we're going to be looking at some families who are extremely cheap. You want to know what else is cheap but high quality?
Alright, we got brand new merch, guys. Look at this.
Looks pretty cheap.
It's so beautiful. It's got a line of difference. It even goes around the back. It's so sad.
It's cheap and all your friends will be jealous. So cap it first line of scratch.
Anyways, guys, let's just get right into the video. Let's see how cheap these people actually are. I'm kind of a cheap person, but I have like this.
Hi, my name is Vicky Smith, and I'm an extreme cheapskate. Here's my husband, John. He's a butcher. We have 10 children. I still live at home.
Hey, you there.
And I've always just been a cheapskate. And the more kids I have, the cheaper I've gotten.
Well, why do you keep having kids? Tana? Wait, what was her name?
Hi, my name's Vicky Smith.
Her name's Vicky. Freaking Vicky, dude. How many kids does she have? 1, 2, 3, 4, I think 4 or 5 kids. When you get more kids, you can't be cheaper, right? You can't be spending more money. House support, food for your kids, clothes for the kids, like schools for the kids, it's all expensive. Okay, how about you stop having kids, Vicky?
This is the living room, and it's pretty bare. We don't want to go in depth with furniture, so what do you see is what we got.
They have old school chairs. There's just a ladder in the corner. There's an office chair. Like, this is like the cheapest living room ever, dude.
We don't want to go in depth with furniture.
She said she would go into debt if she got furniture. I don't think purchasing her chairs. Vicky, I don't know. I mean, she honestly can't be too poor because she has 5 kids. You can't be poor if you have 5 kids. You just can't.
It's driving me really crazy because you don't have a phone bill. Yeah. Yeah. You spend about $120 a month on a phone bill, and that's just too much.
Hi, Dad.
I just walked over the border. It's just going to walk away.
They got rid of their phone. Okay, Vicky, but what if there's an emergency? What if one of your kids is really hurt and you need an ambulance? What do you get here? And then call the police and walk back? No. God, this is stupid. Like, all these are for emergency. Like, keep telling yourself you're saving a bunch of money. $100 for a phone, which can be very, very useful for things. Not too much. Not a lot. All right, guys, don't like this big cookie. Vicky, just get a phone. It's worth it. And if you do, make sure to buy my dog kids first in the description.
From the
17th. 19th century in a tie-dye shirt that she's wearing right now. Great, great outfits. Come on, Vicky. Buy your freaking kids clothes. Like, what are you doing?
I know Soraya's 13. She's very self-conscious about making sure she's not different from the rest of the girls.
Well, she definitely is a little bit different. She doesn't have a mom. She has a 17th century dress, and that's about it. And she has a cheap mom to the world. So those are kind of things that make her different. Well, there you go. Great job, Vicky. Savage girl, I don't know who this freaking girl is. What the back out of my face, miss?
I sure am.
She's roasted. Literally, she's roasted. Like, what are you wearing, Betty? What is that dress? When'd you get it? 300 years ago? Seriously, though, she doesn't look like a normal 13-year-old girl. Alright, if this girl's got like freaking makeup, she's got eyeliner and everything, she's got her hair curly, she's got like a nice freaking shirt. Like, of course, your daughter is probably gonna get made fun of. Put on to your family, like, it's just weird.
Do you want to go shopping? Because I want some new clothes, so I'm ready if you want to go with me.
Sure. Yeah, my mom. I very rarely give my kids money to go shopping. If I were to just give them $20, that takes me totally out of the picture.
$20, totally out. There's no way you're getting a phone if you're out of the picture. Would you will be if you give your daughter $20? So there is no way that Betty is getting. Seriously, Vicky, you can't be this poor. You just can't. You have kids. You have to spend all that money on house support, food, clothes, all that stuff. There's no way that you're poor, alright? And she owns her own house. Like, granted, she doesn't have furniture or any clothes for her kids, but like, you can spend one freaking dollars on your kid to go shopping with her friend. Normal freaking girl for once.
Sometimes stuff my dad can roll with. That's something I want
to do. Okay, calm it down, little Susie. What the heck? This girl is so sassy and just like straight to the point. So savage, dude.
This is like stuff you would wear and also that my grandma would wear. It's weird that you guys would wear the same thing, but I'm not judging.
Yes, you are, little Susie, alright? Stop being so savage.
I avoid buying anything new. If I can get it used, I'd much rather pay 75% off or less.
The shirt is only $2.
$2 is a lot. $2 is a lot.
Who would you buy with $2? A water bottle nowadays? $2 is not a lot, alright? Don't be freaking crazy.
Well, let's see. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. I don't think so. That's too much.
$10? Way too much. Are you kidding? You can buy it like a Lunchable with that. Maybe 2 Lunchables, but like $10. That's not a crazy amount, alright? Just give your kids some clothes. Like, come on, Vicky.
So which is your favorite shirt?
Okay.
Tell you what, why don't we get this one? I feel so good when I save money.
Mm-hmm, and I'm sure your daughter feels so good being made fun of for having weird 300-year-old looking clothes. It's just all about you, Vicky, isn't it?
Here we go, looks pretty fresh.
My plan for the Robert Roadkill is to make some nice things for my family.
So they want some furs, right? For like a coat or a jacket, right? So they go out and find Roadkill. Oh god, that would be beyond disgusting. Absolutely not. Freaking Vicky. Can we just all
furs are expensive, but if you can find them on the road, you can go out cheaper.
It saves me hundreds of dollars.
Yeah, that's the dead carcass that just got killed probably about 3 minutes ago. Then you're showing your kids this nice. Just great, great parenting. Wonderful. Vicky. No, stop clapping. If you were clapping, stop it.
Stop it.
She doesn't deserve a ride of applause.
The ugly
bacon
that we found was a bunny.
It's pretty fresh.
Oh, yeah, freshly dead. Because it just got ran over about 3 minutes ago. And your daughter's like, oh, this is just a bunny. You're going to be your kid's nightmares over this kind of stuff. This is ridiculous.
Yeah, my neighbor Tammy Yoshikuner, of course, serving barbecued rabbit and a tossed salad made with flowers that we favorite.
Kill and weeds from your backyard at the gourmet meal.
There goes Easter. So we're gonna kill the Easter bunny. Terrible.
told him that it was broken.
Well, that's it for that episode. That's a good one. So let's check out.
My family and I are so cheap
that
we all share our
tub
of water.
So they're forcing their kids to take cold, dirty baths. Great. God, this is like a child abuse. Or a child abuse, like serving kids roadkill. Like, ew, bathing in dirty, cold bath water. Ew. Well, first of all, take a quick shower. Okay, yeah, that's cheap, I guess, but it's so disgusting. What's what I guess? Infinite List here, back with another video. Now, today we are going to be looking at some of the cheapest people ever. Are you guys subscribed to the channel Road to 6 Million? Make sure to hit that subscribe button and the notification button. Do you want to be part of the Infinite Army? Yeah, you freaking do. Hit the subscribe button. Only a couple days left on my massive giveaway, guys. Click that first link in the description. Make sure to do it. Did you do it? You can win a PS4, Xbox One, Nintendo 3DS, $700, and my merch for free. Definitely check it out, guys. But guys, are you ready for this? All right, these people are the cheapest people you'll ever see. It's crazy. You thought you were cheap? Well, no, you're not compared to these people, all right? It's bad. You got six short videos that I'm going to show you guys. Just be prepared, because some of this stuff is just so silly. Wait, he has his clothes in the fridge. Okay, hold up. So this guy puts his clothes in the fridge. So
he doesn't have to use the washer or dryer. Freezer just gets rid of all bacteria? Like, what if there's a giant snake? Does it actually get rid of that? I don't think so.
I could be wrong.
If he's right and just putting your dirty clothes in the freezer gets rid of all bacteria and cleans your clothes, then he's an actual genius. That's amazing. He actually is saving a lot of money on that. But it's also kind of weird. You got friends over and they open the freezer and it's just your perfect wardrobe in there. Like, it's kind of weird. I don't know if it's genius or if it's just unnecessary, but let's just keep watching. Okay, before we get to the soup part, he washes his clothes in the freaking hot tub. So he puts his dirty clothes in the hot tub, washes them, right, dries them out, and then puts them into the freezer, and then it thaws out, and then they're clean. That's disgusting. Putting your dirty clothes in the hot tub, like, bro. I just feel like that's not really sanitary. Let's just keep watching.
I put all the soup in my
No way. He's got some soup. You don't need a microwave. You just need a hot tub. I don't know what is more expensive, though, a microwave or a hot tub. I don't think this is a good life hack, bro, I guess. I think a microwave might be a little bit cheaper. Let's just keep watching.
People probably
use their
microwave every day, and it adds up to almost $40 a month. By using my hot tub, I would say I'm saving
about
$40.
Do you see what he's doing? He's cleaning himself in the hot tub, taking a shower. He said he's saving like $40 a month. Are you really gonna bathe in a hot tub and wash yourself in a hot tub and make your food in the same place that you just took your bath in? That's super weird. I thought I was cheap. I buy, you know, some cheap thing and I try to save my money as much as possible. But this guy, saving $40 a month by bathing in a hot tub, cooking his food in a hot tub, just
what?
He made it through the first one barely.
By the way, I only know underwear and no socks.
two pairs of shorts, no underwear, no socks.
That's all he's wearing.
He's wearing a blue shirt, a red shirt, and a black shirt every day for the rest of his life.
He doesn't need anything else.
He just walks around barefoot. He's one of those people you see in Walmart who are barefoot. First sentence was, following his divorce, this guy just got divorced, right? Let's just take a gander on why he got divorced.
By protecting only the entire house with plastic, I live in a three-bedroom, three-bathroom home with two bathrooms.
Okay, so his old house protected by plastic. It's not one of those houses where you walk in and you're like, oh, it just feels like, it's not going to feel like that ever. You live in a plastic house. But this is why you're divorced, Todd. Frankly, you unwrapped your house.
This is the master bedroom.
This is where you sleep?
Yeah, this is all my bedroom. My bed isn't here.
Oh.
In the closet, all right.
I just don't see the need of heating a whole bedroom. And I can just fill up a small closet with a little space here.
Okay, master bedroom. You got so much room for activities and furniture and bed and everything. I don't want to heat up this whole room and waste all the electricity on this. You just sleep in the closet. It's a master bedroom closet, that's what it is. Todd, what are you doing, man? Just leave it in a closet, like, just look at yourself. Why are you sleeping in a closet?
You could be sleeping in the master bedroom.
Like, what the hell are you doing? Todd, you're making me go crazy.
I'll
it's just the great. The girl stepped on the floor and he's like, what? Whoa!
Excuse me.
What are you doing? Don't step there. I know it's the floor and it's, like, meant to be stepped on, but, like, no, do not do that, or I'm kicking you out. Todd, that is the reason you're divorced, because you're freaking crazy.
The most expensive thing about
everything. Wait, okay, we just started this one, right? But did you guys notice it? Did you guys notice that? Let's just watch it one more time.
The most expensive thing about
everything. Did you notice that time?
Look at her freaking mirror. She literally taped a handheld mirror to her.
Not start, not very good, Dana, alright?
Whoa.
Let's just continue. Oh, God.
I was thinking you guys had a couple items to
sell.
Okay, so this girl is having a bridal party, and she's trying to get the cheapest items for that. She scammed to a random farmer, like, hey, you guys got a bridal party items? Let's just see how this goes.
I don't know, but a lot of stuff that I bought to actually use products.
Kitty litter. She's gonna use kitty litter.
A special play mask.
This is evil. You went to a farm, you got some kitty litter, and now you're putting kitty litter on your friends' faces and saying it's a play mask. No, it's not. It's kitty litter. Come on, dude. What are you doing? Why? Why are you doing that? This is so weird. Putting kitty litter on your friends' faces. Just think about that. It's just a little bit weird, right? Yeah, I think so. Hope you guys agree with me. That had a family member recently pass away, takes the dead family member's clothing, her wear, her furry. Oh, God, that's so weird. Just imagine asking, I know your mom died, but can I have her clothes? Like, come on, I'll just take them for you. That's so weird, dude. Wearing a dead person's clothes, just think about that. That's weird. Guys, that is it for the video. If you enjoyed this really weird video of the cheapest people ever, make sure to drop a like. I can definitely make a part two if you guys enjoyed it. Thank you guys so much for watching till the end. Make sure to comment down below. So, we'll see you guys all in tomorrow's video.
they're making a sequel.
Mm-hmm.
That's disgusting.
No, it's not.
That's a DIY channel. What is it, you guys and girls? Thank you. Welcome back to a brand new video. In today's video, we're going to be going... Sometimes Google Maps isn't always right, as you can tell. I don't know how this happens, but I really like how they still try. If I was there, I would just be like, you know what, it's gone. This was meant to happen. There's no way that's coming out. There's just actually no way. It's stuck, dude. It's like quicksand. Say goodbye to your freaking Mercedes, dude. Why did they bring the car to the beach anyway? And why did they park it so close to the water? I'm guessing they were just chilling there, and then water came, kind of just made the car sink to the ground. Why bring that nice of a car? This is just sad to look at. Like, no, that's such a nice car. Guys, today we're going to be looking at people having the worst day ever. Guys, you can win free money if you just click that first link in the description. It's pretty simple. All you have to do is either click the iOS link or the Android link, and then basically just download apps, and you can get money and gift cards and stuff. Bro, it's so simple. Definitely check it out, guys. Links in the description. Road to 6 million, guys. We're almost there. It's freaking cool. Subscribe with the notifications on. All right, let's get right into the video. So these kids' butts rain on sunscreen. Obviously, it didn't really work too well. For the left kid, some guy was probably just like, nah, alright, you're good. Obviously not. The kid probably hates whoever did his sunscreen though. Like, gee, that's terrible. I hate sunburn. Especially when you have that one friend who just wants to slap it. Like, bro, no, please don't ever do that. I hate it. Okay, this is kind of your fault. Like, there's cones everywhere. You should know. It was probably a sign as well. Like, what are you doing, man? Driving in some. That's a pretty nice car, too. What are with all these nice cars just getting wrecked? Because this guy decided not to look at the signs and all the jokes. Like, look how perfect that sidewalk looked. And then you just gotta ruin it all. They gotta do it all over again. Because you decided to be stupid. Like, oh god, that is a lot of freaking beef. A little fact about me, I'm actually allergic to bees. Infamous fact of the day. So if this was my car, I would just say bye-bye to that car. I wouldn't even try to get the bees away. That's gotta be like at least 1,000+ bees, dude. What the heck? What are they doing? Why do the bees want to be around that car? It's not even that cool of a car. Isn't that like a Fiat? That's a Fiat 500. Well, why do the bees like that car? It's kind of a lame car. Look over here by the tire, dude. Oh, your tire is popped for sure. Honestly, I'm impressed they even got this picture because I would never want to be this close to all these bees ever. You would die. Well, time to cancel your car. Don't reach in there. I really hope you didn't reach in there and get your car. Bro, that is disgusting. I would 100% cancel that car right after. I'd be like, okay, well, there goes my money. I hate going in these things. They look terrible and they're always clogged and they always smell
disgusting.
I wonder if he actually did leave his car there. And then someone probably tried to get that car out. Someone probably did. Someone 100% touched that car and picked it out of there. Because the next person probably saw it and was like, oh, money. People will do a lot of things for money, guys. And on that day, Jerry's self-esteem went down by 100%. That is so sad. Just imagine stepping on a scale and then it breaks. Especially a glass scale. This is terrible because, first of all, his self-esteem lowers by a lot. And then also, you get glass in your feet. That's just a terrible day.
I feel very bad for this guy. This is a sad day.
Jerry, I think you need to cut back on the cupcakes. I think that might be a sign that you're eating a little bit too many cupcakes at night.
Oh,
well, I'm glad this is a picture and not a video because I don't want to see Fluffy the dog pee all over.
This is terrible, dude.
Why did the dog pick right there?
This girl's just trying to chill in the sun, and Fluffy's gotta come over and ruin her day.
Oh, this would be terrible. You just sleep in, and you wake up to the freaking pee on your face. Pillow?
No, dude.
Why would you lay that way? Why is he so far out, dude? You're obviously gonna get hurt.
Come on, dude.
You should have at least laid the other way. I feel like that way, he would have been fine. But no, he decided to want a bike wheel in his crotch area, and that's just no fun. All three of these kids thought this was a good idea. And whoever took this picture, like, four people thought this was gonna go well.
No.
You're all wrong. Come on, where's the smart friend in the group? Stephen Montgomery stuck in the ground. The guy with the mic's like, yo, where's my cameraman? This guy's stuck in the ground. We gotta get this footage. What even is this? How do you get stuck in the ground? And why is he being filmed? Like, why don't people help him out of the ground? You gotta get that footage. You gotta get that clickbait. Stephen, I'm sorry no one helped you out. They just wanted to film you and clickbait you. Because honestly, I would watch this. It would be kind of funny seeing some guy stuck in the ground. It makes sense why they wanted to film it. Have the decency to help out. What could they be asking him right now? Steven, how does it feel to be stuck?
stuck in the ground. Well, it's not too great. I kind of wish you guys would help me out.
Steven, how did you get stuck in the ground?
Well, I kind of just fell in here. Can someone help me out?
Oh, no, dude. How are you going to get down now?
You just got to jump.
Or call a friend, but if you don't have any friends, then you just got to jump.
I'm sorry.
Or another way you can do it is if you have a pool, you could jump in the pool and then you could fill in, put it on YouTube and clickbait it and get a million views, dude.
I'm just going to say, if it's a windy day, I don't think I would go on the roof in the first place because it's kind of dangerous and also your ladder's going to fall like it just freaking did. Tips from infinitalists, don't go on your roof on a windy day.
Whoa, okay, so this is amazing. This guy sculpted this out of clay. That, oh, God, that's just terrible. Don't know which one I like better, though, the right and the left, because they're both pretty great.
I'm just trying to picture that feeling after dropping this masterpiece on the ground. You just feel like, I just spent weeks on this project just to drop it, and now he's got a smushed face.
I feel terrible for this guy, because I know how long it takes to do it.
I had a pottery class, and it takes a long freaking time.
Oh, I feel bad for the dude.
Oh, God, what happened here?
You definitely must be allergic to everything.
I'm pretty sure this is like that allergic test to where they like poke you with little things just to see exactly what you're allergic to. I think I did this one time, and I was allergic to like grass and trees, bees.
Not like deathly, but just like a little bit allergic.
Especially in that area. I wonder what's going on there.
I have terrible allergies in the summer.
To all my fellow friends who have allergies,
I relate. It's terrible.
It's tough. You know, I like sneeze every 2 seconds, dude. It's the worst. Chadley got hit with a wet one today.
That's gotta suck.
That would be so embarrassing, bro.
You just had to sit there, didn't you?
This looks like a military thing. Like, this guy's dressed in camo. There's like military dudes back there.
In front of everyone, you got a sprinkler to the freaking head.
Think of it like this. Free water.
Oh.
If you were ever thirsty, well, now you're not. You're good to go.
Be positive.
I was baking a cake, and I didn't realize that I dropped my phone into the cake. I'm crying.
Oh,
how do you drop your phone into a cake
without noticing, dude?
That's honestly kind of impressive. How did you not see your phone in the freaking cake?
What? I mean, the phone looks like it's still working.
Or is this the new cake phone case?
The new Apple cake case?
Now you can lick cake off your phone.
So that's kind
of
neat.
So apparently this is ranch. God, someone spilled a giant bucket of ranch. That's gotta be the worst day.
How do you get cleaned off like this? It'd be terrible just mopping it up.
It's just gonna spread all over the floor. It's gonna be hard to clean up. Like, dude, this is terrible.
I feel so bad for whoever has to clean this up, dude.
Like, it's gonna be under that. It's gonna be under all of those things, dude. It's gonna be terrible. And it's probably gonna smell like ranch in there for the next year.
What?
What the heck? The bottom just fell off while he was cooking.
That would be a terrible day. Just imagine you're cooking your dinner and then your freaking bowl just broke.
What is this even happening?
He was just trying to have a nice potato, carrot, and meat dinner.
And then the freaking bowl had to break, dude.
What are you doing?
What? Did it get too hot or something? Like, how does it just break off perfectly? It's kind of impressive.
Okay, why? How does this even happen?
Seriously, how does it get this bad?
I feel very bad with those cars in the middle. Like, oh, they're gonna be there for a while.
How did this happen? Because there's like sideways cars there, and then there's like other side. Like, what?
Just looking at this longer is making me confused. Because seriously, how did it get this bad?
This is really bad. What was the worst traffic in the world? And then there's a giant bus blocking. Everyone.
5 o'clock traffic, man.
Okay, I don't know what's going on in this picture, but I really feel bad for that guy.
What happened to this freaking boat, dude?
This is terrible. That guy is not gonna have a good time. I can already tell right there. I really don't know how this even happens to your boat. Maybe it was like hanging off of something and then something snapped and then his boat fell in the water face first and he was on there trying to fix something. I don't think I would even know.
This is insane, dude.
I feel bad for you, Jeffrey. Alright, chill out there.
If this happened to your boat, I feel like it would sink as well. Like, there's no way you're recovering the boat if it falls face first in the water, right?
I don't know, I feel like it would just go down, but maybe I'm not.
I don't know anything about boats.
Guys, that is it for the video. I really hope you did enjoy this.
If you want more videos like this, you know what to do.
Drop a like.
Thank you guys all so much for watching till the end. You the actual best. I'm doing a giveaway, by the way, if you didn't know. If you click one of the links in the description, you'll see it. You can win a PS4, Xbox One, $100, and Nintendo 3DS, and my merch, dude, for free.
Why wouldn't you want to join, honestly? You definitely should.
But yeah, guys, I will see you guys all in tomorrow's video. What's going on, guys? Infinite Lists, you're back with another video. Now, today, we're looking at some older people yelling at kids. These clips are actually insane. Some people get so mad. But guys, do you want to get shouted out on this channel? I think you do. All you have to do is be subscribed, turn on notifications, and comment down below saying that you did that. If you'd like a shout out just like this person did, you're the freaking best. I am following back a lot of people on Instagram right now. My Instagram is @infinite_lists right there. Go follow me and I will be following people back. Now, I actually post pretty dope pictures, not gonna lie, so yeah, check it out. But yeah, guys, let's just get right into this video. Let's play the first clip. Smash that like button, and yeah, let's just press play in 3, 2, 1.
Yes, you!
He's tall!
Yo, so he's really tall apparently, and the bus driver thought he was standing up or something just because he's tall. Like, that's insane. How much do you guys to try to guess how tall I am? I'm not really that tall, so there is a little hint for you guys. But yeah, guess in the comments. I'll be liking some people's comments if you get it right. You were walking here first.
Take your dog away.
Exactly. What was that little tantrum?
World Star!
World Star? Jesus!
Hi.
What's wrong with this lady?
The next day!
Okay, I don't know what was going on there, but she said that her dog is scared of skateboards, so they should leave. But it's a public park? Like, what? I don't understand what just happened, but that was ridiculous. That lady just freaked out. She said, we were here first. Leave? Like, no? It's a public park. Oh, yeah, dude. Freaking wheelie here. Uh-oh. Is that a cop? Oh, no, it's not a cop. How young is this kid?
I'm sorry.
You can get killed that way. Censoring what she said, but jeez. Oh, this is amazing. That was great. I need something like this to happen to me where I can film it and show you guys. Like, that is so funny. Just people, just stupid people raging. That's great. I love clips like that. What the? What is she saying? Space. That was amazing. The thing is, I didn't understand one word he said. And that guy's face basically was my date, like the whole time. Like, I don't know what she said. He doesn't know what she said. But it's amazing. Best clip ever. I don't know what's going on. I think she said accident, like he caused an accident or something. I don't know. People, man, just calm down. It's